So today I'm going to show you the completely automated water change system for the 2,000 gallon aquarium. But first we're going to recap with everything I've already shown you just to bring you up to speed. First and foremost, you'll remember that we plumbed the aquarium from behind the 2,000 gallon. Just a couple of 2-inch ABS pipes come out, and we create this kind of sort of contraption for a simple reason. We don't want the 2,000 gallon aquarium to drain completely if the power were to ever go out. So in creating this bit of an overflow, it kind of means that the water level can only go through up to here. And we're not creating any sort of suction because we have two open vents at the top. So essentially water is going to come from behind the 3D background, through the pipe, up over through here, and all the way down and into the 180 gallon aquarium sump, where it's first filtered with some filter floss inside a 5-gallon bucket that we simply drilled some holes in the bottom. And from there, the biological media that it's sitting on is about 4 inches thick. Then it's gotta go through this massive wall of biological media, and then a massive amount of aquarium sponge finally getting returned back to the 2,000 gallon aquarium. This will only account for 50% of filtration, just in case I ever need to disconnect the 2,000 and or disconnect the 375 gallon. I can do so and still have filtration running because I'm going to put a different type of filter on here. The 180 gallon is also tied into the 375 gallon, which is right now just a bit of a holding tank. Sorry for my hands constantly in the way and that light there, but it's currently just housing some Frontosa, koi, monosevrums, angels. We even got a red-tailed catfish right there in the back. And all of that filters through this 180 gallon sump that it's sharing as well, and obviously is returned at the top. Again, we went over this and I showed you how I did everything. And then the other day, I showed you how I drilled into the 1/2-inch thick glass that the 180 gallon has, because when I'm doing my water changes and or adding water to it, I need that somewhere for this to go. We'll come back to that in a minute. Now, I didn't know if this was going to work or not, but when you think about a water change, you add in a bunch of fresh water and then you remove some older water, or technically you remove the older water first. What if I added 20 gallons of water to this tank and then removed 20 gallons from over there? Basically, if I add 20 gallons in here, it displaces the water volume. That extra 20 gallons has to overflow into the sump, and that's where I can remove that extra 20 gallons of water volume. Technically, I'm not just removing the same water that I'm adding into it, because the dilution takes far too long. So I wanted to do something cheap. This might look familiar. Basically, if you want to water your plants and put them on a timer, like a sprinkler or anything like that. So for me, I've got this timed to come on every day at 8 a.m., at 2 p.m., at 8 p.m., and at 2 a.m. every 6 hours. And when it does, it turns on for 7 minutes. Water's going to turn on for 7 minutes and then shut off. It's going to go through this carbon filter and then this garden hose that leads back to the 2,000 gallon aquarium. It's not scheduled to come on for a couple of hours, but I'm gonna go ahead and run a quick test. We'll do it for 7 minutes. Here, turn on. So water's going through it now. We'll come over to this side, and it's just pumping in through the back. Obviously, everything's kind of ugly right now. It's not very pretty, but again, I'm just testing some things out right now. I just wanna actually show you how quickly the water comes out. That's fast. That's a lot of water coming out. And it does that for 7 minutes straight. How much water is coming out in those 7 minutes? Well, I've been running an abundant amount of tests, and it is almost every single time it's 19 gallons. Sometimes it's 18 and a half, sometimes it's 19 and a half, but for better math, we're gonna call it 20 gallons. 20 gallons gets added to the 2,000 gallon aquarium 4 times a day, 80 gallons a day, or 560 gallons a week. All that water is currently flowing in there. It has to overflow through the 2-inch pipe because the return pump's only adding a certain amount of water in. So absolutely any extra water, whether it's a gallon an hour or not, it's going to overflow in the sump. The sump would clearly fill up with all that extra water if I didn't do something about it. Now, at one point I was gonna put a pump on a float switch, meaning that when the water level rises, the pump will automatically turn on and pump out the water. I thought, let's eliminate one moving part. You know, I'd rather have only a couple points of failure. For example, if the valve inside that timer quits, then it's going to continuously either fill the tank or nothing at all, and I need this to continuously drain until I see that it's an issue. So we drilled the tank, and this 3/4-inch pipe that's on a slant, it has got to be on a slant, goes out and through the wall where I originally had the drip system about, or the water change system, about 5-6 years ago. And since the water level's always incredibly accurate in that sump, it should already be draining. And it does, it just drains right out here. I'm gonna have to figure out where I wanna put this water, but again, it's just testing it right now. After that's been running for 7 minutes, it simply shuts off, the water level everywhere kind of equalizes, and everybody goes back to normal. I've been testing continuously for about 3 days. One of the things that I need to know, for example, is what happens during a power outage. Well, when I do a power outage simulation, water from the 375 drains into here, as well as the 2000. And what's going to happen is the water level in the sump is going to rise. If it wasn't drilled though, the tank would probably overflow because about 20 gallons or more needs to come back into the sump. But because I lose that 20 gallons through the bulkhead, when the power does turn back on and the pumps start up again, the water level is going to drop. But only to about half, meaning that the sump can still run until the next water change cycle occurs and another 20 gallons increases. So not only will I never have to top up the aquariums because it's constantly being topped up, I'll also not have to do any water changes, and I can increase the frequency and the amount by as much as I need or want. And you might be asking, well, do you have to heat the water first? And the simple answer is, with over 2,500 gallons in combined water between the two, the simple answer is absolutely not. 20 gallons of cold water is what I'm adding every 6 hours. That 20 gallons does not affect the 375 or the 180. By the time that water gets over there, it's all been equalized and kind of heated back up. But during the initial few minutes, it drops this tank's temperature by about 0.1 to 0.2 degrees Celsius. So it's literally nothing to worry about. So no water changes, no top-offs of filling the tank up of due to evaporation. I just got to, you know, really clean the glass and feed the fish. That's essentially all I have to do. Just kind of enjoying it. And, you know, one of the things about owning a massive aquarium like this is when you have to deal with a lot of water management and you spend more time kind of doing the water changes, it can get expensive. It can get incredibly time consuming, and I just eliminated all of that. And I did it simply because all of this area is the big tanks, but I'm going to have so many other aquariums in here that I have to do things manually and take care of. I'm just trying to lighten the load. Plus, what these water changes are going to do long term is offer me far more consistency in terms of temperature as well as water quality. Meaning that if I forget to do water changes 1 week and I gotta do them the next, the quality is going to be continuously bouncing around, and I risk, you know, putting them through any sort of stress. But this is going to entirely eliminate it. Now, here's the fun part. This thing here was like $50. I already had these, but originally I bought them new for, I think, $8 a piece. This is some RV hose meant for drinking water. So $20. So, I mean, I'm about $80 into that setup right there. Ignore my hot water heater. It's 6 years old. It was supposed to be replaced a little while ago. The top is rusting because there used to be a leak and I never seen it. And now it's all rusted up, but I'll replace it shortly. Bulkhead was $5. Drill bit I already had, but let's call it $10. All the plumbing supplies, another $20. Let's round up, call all of this stuff $30. So all in all, my complete water change system cost me about $100-$120. Easily one of the cheapest that I've done so far. And likely probably the most similar to a real water change, meaning take water out, put fresh water in. But since I can't really rely and or do I trust too many moving parts, instead I'm adding 20 gallons here. The water level is going to rise in here, overflow here, 20 gallons is removed. I end up with about 20 gallons of fresh water. There's absolutely no way all that fresh 20 gallons is going down the drain immediately, if you get what I'm talking about. Now I want to figure out different types of water change systems, especially for this racking system. I might end up going with a drip system for the entire fresh water, whereas the salt water is most likely just going to need an auto top-off system, which I'm going to do for that no matter what. And or maybe I continue to tie tanks into the 2000. One of the things I'd love to do is tie piranha tank into it. Now that would be an interesting one because I just got to drill through the side of it.
Ooh, sun's really coming in here right now. Ooh, I love the way the tank looks. Let me see if I can adjust the camera so you can see what I see. You really can't beat natural sunlight on a tank. I love the shimmer and stuff. Oh yeah, and the piranha are just absolutely gorgeous when they go through those rays of sun. Isn't that something? In order for me to add this tank to the entire system, one of the things that I could do is simply drill into the side, and instead of having the hose go to the 2000, I add the hose to the 700 gallon. All that extra water will overflow into the 2000, which in turn it overflows into the 180. But basically then, they would just be getting wastewater from the 700. What I would need to do is not only have the water going in here, but also have a return from the 180 gallon sump going here as well. And that's something that we're going to look at in the future, is tying the 700 into the 2000, into the 375, into the 180 gallon tank.
And literally all that's going to take is drilling into the side of the 700, adding a return pump from the 180 gallon aquarium, and then everything's completely filtered and on the same system. 700 plus 2000 plus 375 plus 180 equals, so we'd have over 3,300 gallons of aquariums all filtered on the same sump, all essentially carefree. I'm not going to have to take care of them. All their water changes are done, top-ups are done. I'll never really have to touch them again besides kind of keep the glass clean and feed the fish, which is kind of like what we'd all like to do. Anyways, that is the automatic water change system for the 2,000 gallon aquarium, as well as the 375, the 180, etc. I'm absolutely in love with it. One of the best working thus far. Of course, we'll update in the near future of how things go, but for $100, I thought, let's give it a shot. I already have the tank. I already have a hole in the wall for the drain. I already have an attachment, because you guys know that I used to run drip systems out here, as well as automated water changes. So in the cold water feed that goes into the hot water heater, I had this put onto it so I could do my drip system and or automatic water changes, so I just added this onto it.
So the fact that these water changes, I'm on a well, so my water's free. Basically adding 20 gallons of water to the 2000 doesn't take a tremendous amount of water pressure either. Plus I don't have to heat the water first, because once it gets into the tank, it essentially balances out. The water volume is too great. I might have to increase the size of these water changes eventually, and that will be easy by simply turning the timer up by a few minutes each time. I simply had to calculate how many gallons do I get per minute, and for me it's about 2.7. so I mean, if I wanted to put the timer on 10 minutes, I'd do a 27 gallon water change, or if I do it for 11 minutes, I'm going to get a 30 gallon water change, and etc. It's very simple and easy to calculate once you run countless tests. I'll show you how I did my test.
This little sink holds 19 gallons of water. I took this hose off and I put it in here, and I set this timer up for 7 minutes, and I filled this up over and over and over again. Every time it filled it up, but it didn't overflow, it was always at around the same mark, and that holds 19 gallons.
That's the automatic water change system. Incredibly simple, incredibly cheap, and incredibly easy. Hope you've enjoyed it. This is kind of my journey to making everything absolutely awesome out here. And if you're enjoying these videos and you don't want to miss any of them, make sure you subscribe or you will miss them. See you guys in the next one.